Hey guys, so Learndash has a lot of payment gateway that you can choose. I believe they have Stripe, they have Checkout, they have WooCommerce, they have PayPal, and a lot more. So in this tutorial, I'm gonna show you the basic Learndash payment gateway 101, how you can configure it, and so on and so forth. So yeah, if you are interested in this video, then stay tuned because I'm gonna show you how. And again, I also have other tutorial in Learndash, so I highly suggest that you check my playlist. I'm gonna put it on the link description below if you are interested. So, all right, let's begin. 1, 2, 3. So let's start first on the basic and the built-in payment integration. So before we configure anything, make sure under the general section, you set the login and registration enable this part. And also, I highly suggest as well that you turn off the auto enrollment for the admin so you don't need to switch from different account when you are testing your courses. So disable this one for the meantime while you haven't configured your payment gateway yet, and then you go into the PayPal settings tab. So again, Learndash settings, general, and then PayPal settings tab. Now this is super self-explanatory, actually nothing really complicated. You just need to put in your email address, your PayPal email address, what currency do you prefer, what's your PayPal account. Actually, it's based from Philippines, so let me double check that. What's the code for the Philippines? Okay, it should be PH. Okay, and then cancel URL is when someone did a cancel for a purchase. You can also add a thank you page for that. And for the PayPal return, this will be your thank you page. What if they purchased or they completed your order? PayPal notify URL. I'm not touching this part here. So yeah, I'm not so sure about this part, but you can keep it as a default. And then use sandbox, PayPal sandbox. Yeah, you may enable this part there and then click yes. Okay. Now, once you've already filled this up, if you go into your course, you can try to create a course to see how it looks on your end there. So if you visit in the course page, and since I disabled the auto enrollment, if I click this part called take this course, it will be redirected to the PayPal payment gateway. Now, if you don't want to use PayPal, then you can use some add-ons on Learndash, but you need to purchase on their license. Okay, so now if you don't want to use PayPal, then you can use their add-ons. So there is an add-ons in Learndash called Stripe. Let me double check that. So there is a Stripe, and there's also a WooCommerce. So if you want to connect your WooCommerce, if you want to connect your courses on your WooCommerce payment gateway, that's also possible. So just activate that, click add new, and upload the plugin and look for WooCommerce. So this one, Learndash WooCommerce 1.50. So in the WooCommerce, the settings is a bit different. Because what you need to do here, if you activate that part, is on the course pages of your Learndash, you need to choose the close enrollment. So courses, and go to the edit tab, and then under the settings area, instead of using this built-in payment gateway on Learndash, you can choose this close one. So if the price is $29, you can then add something like, you need to create a product first in the Learndash. So how you can do that? So for example, this is FB course as an example. In this part here, choose the product data as course. And then what is the related course? It's FB thing. And click that. And of course, you need to add information on your product page, right? So this is the product course. So again, after you generated your product page in WooCommerce, you can then link that in here. But there is other link as well that you can use in order to redirect them to the checkout page instead of the product page. Oh, I just forgot. I haven't put any prices on the WooCommerce, so make sure you put a price. So under the general, it is $29 as an example, and we will update that. Let's see how it looks now. Okay, $29. And of course, again, you need to fill in the details as much as possible. So in here, instead of putting this part, this thing, like if I have that and I go into the product itself, like if I go to the product and I go to the take course, like this is fine, but I just don't want to give them additional process to do the checkout. So instead of redirecting them to the product page, I want them to redirect to the checkout page. So we will gonna replace this part in here. Instead of this product slash FB course or this plug, I would choose this part here. So add cart something, blah blah blah. And then you just need to change the product ID. So where you can access the product ID. So simply go to the products, all products. And then here, what is your product ID? It's 52914. So we will replace that with that product ID. And if I update that, and let's go back to the course pages again. And if I hit take this course, oh, I need to remove the AdSense rather. So if you check, if I click that, it automatically goes to the checkout page, which is great. So that is what I'm looking for. And then we're ready to configure the checkout. One more thing is you need to make sure that you accept guest checkout into your WooCommerce. So go to the WooCommerce and go to the settings area. And on the settings area, there is like here under the payments tab. No, not in the payments. I think it's in the general section here. So on the general section, let me just take a look where it is located. I think in the product page. Yeah, on the product tab, you can, I'm just trying to figure out where it is located. Yes. Okay, so you need to make sure that this is checked. You need to allow the guests to place order even though they don't have an account. Otherwise, your checkout will not work because we will assume that a lot of the enrollees doesn't have an account to your website. So you need to check this part, this section instead of this section. Okay, you can actually check everything there. Allow customer to create an account. Yeah, the customer took an account on my page. Yeah, that's fine. So you just need to configure this guest checkout and account creation as well. Remove personal data from the order of request. Remove access to the downloads. I'll get back to that. But yeah, so if I click that, I mean, it should look like this. And yeah, that's how the payment gateway options in Learndash works. And this will also help you to simplify your process in terms of the checkout. We know that simplifying your checkout can decrease your abandon rate. So you need to configure that. Hope it helps. And if you have any question or concern, don't hesitate to comment down below.